In this video, we're going to have a walkthrough the Tradego platform offered to you by Yugo and provided by Saxo Bank. The Tradego is the platform by default, whether you want to trade leverage products, whether you want to trade normal stocks or ETFs, non-complex products, the Tradego is the platform where you want to go. Well, to enter the platform, you go to the website of yugoinvesting.com. The platform, you can see that here in front of you. Then you go to login and you go to login to Tradego. Once you're in the first page, you will see a risk warning. That is basically your appropriateness for different products. So different products that you have enabled in the platform, for those products, you will need to do an appropriateness test. The results of those appropriateness tests will be shown to you each time when you log in. So in this specific scenario, you see that some of the tests are not terminated. You will have the status not taken. For these products, you see that this specific account is being considered not appropriate. And for the products below here, so the non-complex products, this client is appropriate. Well, you click on accept. You have to do that each time. It's once you're more familiar with the platform and logging in very often, then obviously you will click on accept by default directly, but it's something that you need to do. Then when you get into the platform, you will see this screen. And this screen is built up out of three main windows. It's the trading section of, in this case, the Tradego platform. You see the trading section. It has a default window here at the left top of the screen. I'm looking at my screen, but of course I need to navigate through the platform, so I can't be looking at you all the time. This trading section has three windows. So the watch list section is allowing you to build, as it says, your own watch list. The section here on the right is giving you the product overview, it's giving you the charts, and it's giving you the option chain. And here at the bottom, you will be seeing your positions. This is an account with no funds on it, so it's a very minor amount of funds. So you won't see any positions here, but you will have a clear understanding of how it works. Let's start with the section of the watch list. To make a new watch list, you simply click on new. We can call this test. And you save the watch list. Say for instance, you want to start adding instruments to this watch list, stocks that you are following, like for instance, Apple. You type in Apple, you get the CFD and you get the stock, you click on the stock and it will be added. It says here, instrument added to your stock list or your preferred list or your watch list. Let's say you also want to add a stock from Europe. Let's say you want to add ING, the Dutch bank. On ING group, and you will see that also this instrument is added. So you have here a clear idea of some watch list. Then you click here, for instance, on different watch lists that I already created. So for instance, here the IBEX, which is the Spanish stock exchange. You will see that the stocks that are in the IBEX will appear here. Let's click on one of these stocks. Hey, what we see here, we can see that the product overview is changing to the product in this case that I have selected, Banco Bilbao Vizcaya Argentaria, which is the BBVA bank. If I want to change watch list, I can do the same thing again, go to Dow Jones, and here I have the Dow Jones index. Click on Coca-Cola, and you get all the information that you need to determine whether Coca-Cola is a buy for you or not. You have the stock price, the bid, the ask, the low, the high. You have here at the top also the target price based on analyst reports that are bundled into a consensus into the platform. You have the analysis showing you more information from FactSet. It's all external, right? So it's not our opinion. It's not the opinion of Saxo Bank. It's from FactSet. And they say there's an implied return possibility on this case on Coca-Cola of 10.4%. The fundamentals showing you how many times am I paying the earnings? In this case, you've got a price earnings of 24. You've got a dividend yield of 3.1%. You can see also here the earnings per share, the dividend, all the information that is required to determine whether this stock is valid to buy or not. Then we can click on charts. And you'll see that I already have here a chart prepared for you with different indicators. So we can clean this up by just clicking on any of the indicators and the indicator will be deleted. So for instance, here I have Coca-Cola with the RSI and the MACD. Adding indicators is really simple. You can use this section here, add indicator, and any indicator that you have heard about, that you've learned, that you are using will be available for you here. If you want to change the parameters of the indicator, you click simply on the parameter, you click on the small wheel here, and it will show you the periods, for instance, to be able to change. You can change the colors, anything that you like. That is self-learning. I'm not going to go into too much detail on that because I think you will be managing that on your own. This little button, many times clients forget about this, that they say, hey, my screen is different, I can't go back. You click simply on these four arrows and the screen will be going back into the original layout. Clicking on the option chain, also here you will be seeing the options, in this case on the Amsterdam Exchange. You can change that also. You can link the screens also here. So if I click on instrument link, you will see that the options of Coca-Cola will appear. I have all the different strikes. I can click here on the expiry dates. I can select them all, or I can select a specific one. Let's select this one, the 22nd of March. I mean, the market in the US at this moment is still closed, so I don't have the prices live for you, but they are available in the platform if you want to have the real-time data as soon as the market is opening. I can simply click on one of the bid prices and you will see that automatically I get a risk warning here that the product in this case is not appropriate for me. You can see that the as there is no funds on this account, you will see there's a margin utilization warning. This selling of this call will bring me into a margin call situation, which you obviously don't want. All the details of the trade will be shown to you here in the ticket below. You will see your margin impact, the initial margin, the maintenance margin. You can add conditions to this. There's many possibilities within the platform possible. Then the option so as I said here, if you want to move on and you want to look at for instance your positions, well, they are here. You can select and filter on positions by clicking on the filter. You can also click here on, and you will be seeing different amount, different accounts. If you have different sub accounts, also very important. So sometimes people call us up and say, hey, I have less positions. Where are my positions? That is because you have selected either one of the sub accounts and you're missing out the other ones. The orders will be explaining itself. Order blotter, that are the trades that you have done during a specific day. Then I would like to highlight also a beautiful functionality within the platform, which is the screener. The screener allows you to search for stocks or bonds or any sort of instrument. You can see that here. Stocks, ETFs, mutual funds, bonds, FX, CFDs, contract futures, any product that you think is interesting for you. You can click on here on ETFs, for instance, and you can start looking for ETFs. ETFs on what? ETFs on equity I'm looking for. And I'm looking for ETFs with a annual return that is higher than, let's say, 20%, 30%. Oh, it's shooting over. So here, I have done that on 20%. I still get a lot of results. Put it on 30%. Still more than 250 ETFs with a annual return higher than 30%. Imagine that, guys. That's a lot. Morningstar ratings, let's put 5 stars. See if that filters down. Yeah, we go down to 110. Let's say that we only want to have ETFs in euro. 43 ETFs. Okay, so now what you see is you get a whole list with ETFs in euro, in stocks. And what we can do is we can add columns. So if I want to see a price change on a yearly basis, you can select on that as well. So here I filtered it out. So you see the VanEck Semiconductors ETF has done 61% over the past 12 months. Isn't that amazing? I can click on it and you will see that if I minimize the screen again, automatically going to the product overview, the information of this VanEck Semiconductor ETF will appear here at the right of the screen. Can read more about this ETF. I can compare it to his participants in the same market. I can click on the profile, give me information on how many assets are in this ETF. I can click on documents and look into the key information document, which is obviously a requirement. If you want to trade a US ETF, you know that it's going to be difficult because US ETFs are prohibited if they do not provide a key information document in Europe since 2018 because of MiFID. Looking at the charts, same procedure as before. This is the chart because I linked it automatically. It picks up the chart of the VanEck Semiconductor ETF. That is that. Clicking on research, then I get a page with, for instance, also here, your Hugo Your Coach page. Hugo Your Coach is a page that is built specifically for you. It gives you information about, for instance, how to activate stock lending, how to boost portfolio returns. It gives you inspiration on how you can trade in specific instruments, day trading, gap trading, lower the cost of your ETFs and shares by dollar cost averaging. There's a lot of useful information here. Also, if you want to know more about specific functionalities in the platform, how to calculate the value of a stock, Forex and disclaimer fill-ins, there's a lot of information here. Please go and have a look at that because it will be very, very interesting for you. You also have the possibility to look into our vlogs. We can look at sustainability within the platform, etc. Trade Signals, not going to highlight it too much. It's basically a tool from a third-party vendor that allows you to follow signals. News, it explains itself. You see that the GDP information here of Europe or the US. The market analysis gives you really specific information. It's more content of third-party vendors or people from Saxo Bank. The calendar, I personally like to use it quite a lot. It gives me clear information what is coming out today. So I tend to select for this the US, and you see that's already selected. And you see, for instance, today you have the energy information, EIA, coming out with oil information, the estimations, of course, and then what is really coming out that is up today at 4:30. So you see there's a lot of extra stuff into the platform that might be useful for you. Equities, also interesting. If you want to know, for instance, what has been performing the best in the previous session or during the session, this is on the S&P 500 of last night, because you can see it's not yet 3:30 yet, so the market in the US is not yet open. You can see that this stock had a return yesterday, Phibro Biologics, never heard of it, of 88.4%. And this stock here, Alkaline Water Company, unfortunately yesterday lost 80% of its value. So you can see, maybe useful, maybe not. In the portfolio section, you can click on your different accounts, all accounts. And then here you can see what you have in your portfolio at this moment. You can see your orders, your performance, your transactions, your corporate actions. And here, very useful, you can find all the historical reports. By clicking on this, you will have any type of report. Most of the people use this for their last year's information for the tax authorities. You can download any report that you might need that can comply with your local tax authorities. The nice thing about the platform is that it normally always complies with any tax authority around the globe. Within this section here, you can click also, you have the platform settings. In the platform settings, you can, for instance, this is an important one, the position netting. Sometimes clients, they say, well, my position is not gone yet. That's because they have a position netting enabled. So that means that the position will remain in your portfolio until the end of the trading day. And then once the position is netted, when the day trading day is ended, your position will be released from the portfolio. The trading products, if you want to add a specific product to your portfolio, you can just disable or enable them, in this case, answering my question, to your universe. And obviously you will be required to do the specific appropriateness test. Based on the appropriateness test, you will be receiving a risk warning that is suited specifically for you. That is that. Deposit and transfers allows you to withdraw or fund money, so information to how to fund your account, but also gives you information on how to withdraw money from your account. You can subscribe to market data from this section. You can go here to other, and you will see that you can look at upcoming margin and collateral changes, application access. These things are not so relevant for you. The activity log can be useful sometimes. You can request for new accounts, sub accounts, saving accounts, any sorts of information that you might need if you want to do a portfolio transfer from another bank to your Yugo account. You can do that around here. Updating your personal data. Yeah, basically all the data, all the information is here. Downloading reports is here as well. Account statements, annual report, any information that is required, please go into the platform and you will be finding it there. Placing a trade, yeah, that's actually the most important thing. Any stock, any instrument you want to buy, just click here in the product overview on the trade section and it will give you a trade ticket. The trade ticket speaks for itself. Select always the correct account, the sort of order, there's different possibilities, market limits, stops, trading stops, stop limits, anything like it. Also, use only the simple order, which is market limit, stop, no difficult ones. Buy or sell, speaks for itself. Number of shares, the limit for which you want to buy, and the duration. Place order, and your trade will be fired to the market. Very small recap of what is possible within this platform, how to use the Saxo TraderGo platform offered to you by Yugo. I think it's an amazing platform. It's quick, it's comprehensive, it's easy to understand. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to reach out to me. I'm more than happy to explain to you one-to-one if you need a specific functionality, for instance, a chart or a specific order type. More than happy to help you, and I hope to hear from you soon.